So the first exercise is a just simple shoulder smash with a lacrosse ball. I like to do it on the front where the shoulder connects with the pecs, and kind of go around, just release some tension. And I like to finish off at the back and exactly where kind of the shoulder connects with the scapula. In my case, I really, really feel it kind of gives me a little bit of flexibility and releases some tension. So I kind of really like to do it and kind of take my time with this particular exercise. The next exercise is just simple wall slides. It is very important as you're doing this to keep your lower back, shoulders, elbows, and wrists close to the wall. So don't worry if you can't really get your hands fully extended to the top. It is a very, very challenging exercise and it requires quite a lot of mobility. If you do have bands, kind of using bands to get a little bit of stretch, the side of your back, your triceps, and your shoulder, this is a great option. I like to rotate inwards and outwards just to kind of get a little bit more space and work it a little bit more dynamically than statically. So you can, of course, use bands if that's what you have. It is really, really, really great option. But alternatively, you can also do this, without using bands. So you can just find something to hold yourself onto, and you can again swing to the side a little bit to kind of just get a little bit of extra stretch. So no equipment necessarily required for this one. I really, really like this exercise. You can practically do it anywhere. I like it. It gives me like a nice upper back stretch as well as a shoulder stretch. And there are a couple of variations to this one. You can do it either on your hands. If you want to create a little bit more space, you can go on the tip of your fingers. If you have more flexibility and if you want to get a better stretch, you can also go on your elbows and press your palms against each other, or even put your hands on your shoulder blades. It gives you really, really nice stretch and also pulls your triceps and kind of the backside of your shoulder very, very well. Also, if you do have a foam roller, you can use it to create just a little bit of extra space for the kind of more advanced version of it, pressing your palms against each other, or putting your palms again on your shoulder blades. Another great option, if you have bands, to kind of stretch, the side of your back and kind of get a little bit more, flexion in your shoulder. This is a great option. Just make sure that as you're coming into the exercise and out of it, you also kind of squat a little bit, when you're releasing, so you don't put additional strain on your shoulder. And I kind of like to stay in this exercise for maybe 10, 15, 20 seconds, whatever feels nice. It's great for a warm up and also for a dedicated mobility session, in my opinion. This one is a great version if you do have a foam roller. You can stretch your shoulders very, very nicely, and also your thoracic spine, which I personally find it is definitely a problematic area when rowing. If you do want to get a little bit resistance, you can maybe grab a weight or hold something heavy to kind of give you this additional weight on your in your hands and get this a little bit additional stretch. This is also a great option. I do have problem with my thoracic spine and I do hurt quite a lot. And this exercise has been recommended to me by an osteopath. It looks like crunches, I know, but the focus is actually extending backwards, kind of just creating this, this space and releasing a little bit of a pressure on the vertebrae as you kind of pushing yourself backwards. You can also do this on a chair if you don't have a foam roller. It's a little bit more challenging, but also works. So for the hips, I have seen a lot of rowers having a little bit issues with their hip mobility. So this is a great option to try if you don't have a very comfortable deep squat. You can use bands to kind of get a little bit of extra pull and kind of help you open up your hips. Of course, try to keep your pelvis as close to the wall as possible, and your feet as close as possible to your bum. You can, of course, if you don't have bands, you can do the same version at the wall, without the bands, and you can just use your arms to create a little bit of that stretch, of course. And don't forget to keep your lower back on the floor. If you are comfortable, at least ish, in a deep squat, you can try this variation, which is a deep squat to stand up. And it kind of gives you a very, very nice stretch of your back, also thoracic spine and lower back, and can also kind of give you a very, very good stretch in your hip. If you are more mobile, try doing the so-called deep squat progression, which is kind of a little bit with a twist and keeping your arms up. It's a great multi-joint mobility exercise. And I love doing it when warming up, but also it is fantastic to spend a little bit more time into as you're doing a dedicated mobility session. This is called the perfect stretch, and I also love this as a hip opener. You can add a little bit of twist here, of course, and a little bit of a hamstring stretch. I really, really find this very, very good. Of course, aim to put your elbow on the floor, but if you can't, just try to get as lower as possible. That is totally not a problem. And also, if you can't straighten your front leg completely in the hamstring stretch, don't worry about it. You just stretch as much as you can. But this is also a very, very, very good exercise for a nice hip mobility and just kind of getting a little bit of extra hip opening. If you're really adventurous, you can try some lacrosse ball smashing on your glutes. I find it amazing to release some tension and pain in my glutes and also in my lower back. Just if you're really not accustomed to it, just be careful because it could be quite painful and uncomfortable if you're not used to the pain. So just take it easy if you never tried this before. Alternatively, if the lacrosse ball smash is too much, you can try to roll your glutes on a foam roller. It is really, really nice to kind of just get a little bit of release and remove a little bit of the tension that kind of piles up in the glutes. You can just swap almost like cross your legs by putting your leg on or your foot on the knee just to kind of get a little bit more strain on one glute. This is, now we're coming to having a good ankle stretch. And this is a fantastic exercise to A, test your ankle flexibility, to look for any asymmetries between the mobility of your both ankles. Put maybe 3-4 fingers away from the wall, as you see me doing here, and just see whether you can touch the wall which you need. And move your foot a little bit backwards and kind of work your way towards the wall again, and just see where the mobility restrains you. This is really, really great exercise. I really like to warm up and work my ankle mobility in this kind of little deep squat progression variation. You can also work on your hip mobility, hip opening with this one. And especially if you don't have a good, comfortable deep squat, and you can just hold yourself at a door and kind of swing back and forth, just creating a little bit more, as I said, space within your hips and also working your ankles. I find this very, very soothing. And sometimes when I do a dedicated mobility session, I like to stay in this for maybe 30, maybe 40 seconds. It's very, very comforting. This is a good also option to kind of work on your ankle mobility. I don't know if you can see, but I'm working my back leg as well, and I'm just holding myself a little bit against the wall just for some support. But that also allows you to very, very nicely flex your knee and kind of swing a little bit, to the left and to the right and forward and backwards, and just work that ankle mobility. It's really, really great. Also, let's not forget my favorite, Cossack squat. It's a very, very nice way to also work not only the mobility of your ankles, but also the strength of all the ligaments around it. So I would just do maybe 5 to the side when I'm warming up. It's also very, very nice to kind of work your hips on top of that. So these were my recommended favorite mobility exercises. Hope you like them.